In this video, I discuss the various MCQ related to the psychrometric process. So first we go through the basic process of sensible cooling and heating, then after go through the difference process. Now first MCQ: during the sensible cooling of air, which parameter is decreased? Wet bulb temperature, relative humidity, dry bulb temperatures, specific humidity. So basic thing is that when the sensible cooling is done, at that time, not sensible cooling, even if any sensible process, okay, either it is cooling or heating, okay, there is a no change in the specific humidity, okay, and change in the temperatures. So the answer is the dry bulb temperatures. Now before moving on the answer, I showed this sensible cooling process on the psychrometric charts, okay. This 1 to 3 process is indicate the sensible cooling. So here we see that the inlet temperature is TD1 and outlet its temperature is reduced, okay. So during the cooling, the dry bulb temperature is decreased. So option C is the correct answer. And specific humidity is remains constant, means W1 is equal to W2. So relative humidity is also changed during the sensible cooling process. Okay, it is the increase. The wet bulb temperature during sensible cooling of air remains constant, increase or decrease. So in this image, you check that this inclined line is for the enthalpy as well as for a wet bulb temperatures. Okay, so we see that here, suppose W1 means the wet bulb temperature is there, TW1, here the TW, okay. So moving from this side to this side, at that time value of wet bulb temperature is increased. So here what happened, the wet bulb temperature is decreased. So during the sensible cooling process, the wet bulb temperatures is decreased. So answer C is the correct answers. During sensible cooling of air, specific humidity remains constant, increase or decrease. So in this graph we see here it is the specific humidity. So at the inlet and outlet, specific humidity remains constant. So option A is the correct answer. During sensible cooling, relative humidity remains constant, wet bulb temperature increase, specific humidity increase or a partial pressure of vapor remains constant. Okay, so here you see the relative humidity remains constant. It is the wrong statement, okay, because here it is changed 51 to 52. Wet bulb temperature increase, it is wrong statement, because in earlier we studied that wet bulb temperature is decreased. During that, specific humidity is increased. But here we see that specific humidity is constant. So by default, option D is the correct. Partial pressure of water vapor remains is constant. So option D is the correct answers. During sensible cooling of air, the relative humidity increase? Yes or no? So from this graph here, you see that at this curve, relative humidity is 100. Then we moving this side, relative humidity is decreased. So in this case, the relative humidity is increased. Okay, so this statement is the correct. So option A is the correct answers. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video, and if you not subscribe the channels, then subscribe the channel by pressing subscribe buttons. And for watching the more MCQ related to RSE, the link is provided in the descriptions. Even if you want to understand these processes on the details and another topic related to RSE and mechanical engineering, then also the link is provided in descriptions, or you also visit the playlist for watching this more video. During sensible heating of air, which parameter is decrease? Okay, so during sensible heating, the dry bulb temperature is increased, okay, and the specific humidity remains constant. So here different option is given. Okay, for solving this psychrometric process related MCQ, you at least need to draw psychrometric charts, then you can get easily answers. Okay, so here we see that it is an inlet of the air, and this is the heating coil temperatures, and this is the heating coil temperature is 3 and 2 is the outlet temperatures. Okay, so which parameter is decreased? But this is the heating, then dry bulb is increased, wet bulb is also increasing, dry bulb temperature is also increased, specific humidity remains constant. So we see that the relative humidity is higher here, and at the outlet the relative humidity is decreased. So what is the answer? Option B, relative humidity decreased during the sensible heating process. During sensible heating of air, specific humidity remains constant. Agree or disagree? Okay, we are agree with these statements. Here we already written that specific humidity at inlet is equal to outlet. So this statement is the correct. The dry bulb temperature during sensible heating of air remains constant, increase or decrease. So it is heating process, so by default the dry bulb temperature is increased. You also seen in this psychrometric charts, at the inlet dry bulb temperature is TD1 and at the outlet dry bulb temperature is TD2. So it is increasing because here the temperature is 0 and then right side it is increased. So option B is the correct answer, that dry bulb temperature is increased during sensible heating process. During humidification process, which parameter is increased? Wet bulb temperatures, relative humidity, dry bulb temperatures and the specific humidity. Okay, now here I show you this psychrometric charts of the humidification process. So here we see that the dry bulb temperature is remains constant. Okay, so we take the projection of this line here, then only we get the one point, that means TD1 and TD2 are same. Here you see that specific humidity is increased from W1 to W2. Here you also see that relative humidity is also increased. Here you also see the wet bulb temperature is also increased. Okay, so that is the three answer is correct. But in a MCQ, that is in a different book, the only one answer is given correct, that is a relative humidity. But the three answer is correct. Okay, that is option A as well as option B, and as well as the option D is also correct. Okay. The dehumidification process on the psychrometric chart is shown by horizontal line, vertical line, incline line or a curve line. Okay, so here you see the graph of the dehumidification process. During the dehumidification process, at the constant dry bulb temperatures, moisture is removed from the air, means specific humidity is reduced from W1 to W2. That's why its line is vertical. Similarly, for humidification process, its line is also vertical, but it's moving in upper direction. In dehumidification process, line is moving in downward direction. Okay. And in sensible heating and cooling, this type of MCQ is also possible. During sensible heating and cooling, the line is vertical, horizontal, incline or curve. So during sensible process, it is the horizontals. But during humidification and dehumidification process, line is the verticals. So option B is the correct answer, the line is verticals. The specific humidity during humidification process remains constant, increase or decrease. So here you see in this graph. Okay, so generally humidification and dehumidification process occur at the constant dry bulb temperatures. Only thing is change is the specific humidity. If specific humidity is increased, then it is humidification process. Specific humidity is increased, then it is the dehumidification process. So in this graph you see that the humidification is specific humidity is increased. Okay, so what is our answer? Option B, it's increase. The process of removing moisture from the air without changing its dry bulb temperature is called dehumidification process. Correct or incorrect? So this statement is correct. Process of removing moisture from the air without changing dry bulb temperature is called as the dehumidification process, but this sentence is correct. MCQ is also possible that process of adding the moisture in the air without changing dry bulb temperature is called humidification process. So this statement is correct. But in exam, they may be changed. Wrong statement is also given. The process of removing moisture from the air without changing dry bulb temperature is called humidification process. Then the sentence is wrong. So you need to remember the definitions of all the process. The specific humidity during humidification process remains constant, increase or decrease. So here I show you this diagram from the dehumidification process. Here we see that the humidity is reduced, okay, because line is moving in this downward directions. So here specific humidity at inlet is higher than the specific humidity at the outlet. So here the specific humidity is decreased. So option C is the correct answer. During cooling and dehumidification, dry bulb temperature remains constant, increase or decrease. So now from here the two processes combined. Okay, here cooling is combined and dehumidification is combined. So this is the psychrometric charts of the cooling and dehumidification process. this process 1 to 2 is indicate the cooling and dehumidification process. Okay. So when the cooling is come, the simple thing is that dry bulb temperature is increased. Okay. You not need to graph. Cooling is there, dry bulb temperature is increased. Heating is there, dry bulb temperature is increased. Okay. So what is the answer? That is option C. Okay. Suppose this MCQ asks during the heating and humidification process, dry bulb temperature by default increase during heating process. Okay. Now next MCQ, the specific humidity during heating and humidification process remains constant, increase or decrease. Here you also not need to graph, okay, because what is the word? Heating and humidification. So when the humidification is there, specific humidity is increased. When the word dehumidification is given, at that time the specific humidity is decreased. Okay, so for here I putting this graph. This is the inlet point. 1 to 2 process is heating and humidification. Okay. So we see that the specific humidity is increased from W1 to W2. So in a sum MCQ, you not need to graph. Just basic understanding is required and you are able to give the correct answers. The minimum temperature to which water can be cooled in the cooling tower is at the dew point temperature of there, wet bulb temperature of there, dry bulb temperatures and ambient air temperatures. So what is the correct answer? Answer is the option B. So minimum temperature to which water can be cooled in cooling tower is the wet bulb temperatures of the air. Now more MCQ is covered in a part 2 video, that is MCQ of psychrometric process part 2. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels and don't forget to share with your friend.